Welcome to the Mill Brook Railroad, and today we finally finished the turntable. Oh yes, today we are finally finishing the turntable. So, first thing we got to do to get this thing done is we got to dig out around the turntable ring, make room for that new turntable wall we're going to build. So the tools we're using are very, very simple. They're cultivators, basically, hand cultivators. They've been modified to work as ballast forks between the ties. This other tool I've got, that is a mattock. It's an axe on one end and an adze on the other end. You'll have to look those up. This tool is about 100 years old. Another important thing with a turntable is it's got to move smoothly in a 360-degree circle, and we've got a hump in the ring at this spot that we're digging right now, and dug out this long piece of steel and this short level just to figure out how far off we are. And spoilers, we're still kind of far off, but only in that one spot. At this point, Tony and I decided that the best thing to do would be just to finish making room for the turntable wall. We'll level the ring later. Okay, so here's my hairbrain scheme for laying this wall out. I was taking pieces like this on the side like this, so they're all the same size. So they're on their sides. These are ripped 2x4s. So yeah, and then in the middle like that. And hopefully we'll get the right radius, right diameter. Night of the round table?
Yep. So it's a circumference.
Circumference?
So circumference. One more here for the mat. So we need to screw these together now, don't we?
Yep.
Do we think to pre-drill the holes first?
To pre-drill the holes first is probably not a bad idea.
Did you bring it?
So anyway, this is how I'm thinking of laying it out. And we take this off and screw the top layer into the next one down, that kind of thing.
So basically the process here is to drill, screw, and repeat for 200 pieces, roughly. And we'll see if we get the shape right. Now, my original plan was to make this in quarters so it would be easier to put around the turntable ring. Well, you'll see a little bit later that wasn't exactly the best idea. On projects like this, I tend to just start doing them. Sometimes I miss things, and boy did I miss something big. I didn't measure very well. I didn't establish an actual measurement from the end for each piece. Yeah, where are these going to be placed exactly on top of each other? Well, that bit me at this point, and we had to rebuild a whole section. And then the fourth section we just ended up building in place. Well, here we are at the end of day one, and I'm kind of anxious to get this thing together. So now I'm measuring for a spacer to put the lead track onto. Now, several minutes have passed since that last frame, and I've ripped a piece of 2x4 down as a spacer. I'm going to attach this to the turntable pit wall, and then I'm going to attach the track to it. Now, I still have adjustments to make to the turntable. I'm going to have to bevel the sides so they clear the approach tracks, but, well, it's getting closer anyway. I mean, I probably won't have to redo this part. Maybe. I hope. Oh, this is probably foreshadowing again. Oh well, in for a penny, in for a pound. I made a couple of locking plates out of a piece of aluminum box tubing. Took a bit of cutting on the saw. I probably should have filmed it, but, well, I was in too much of a hurry to get this part done. But here it is. Concept proven. I just gotta drill a hole in it now.
Fresh battery. Got all that scrap out of the way that wasn't a hole. Exactly what I needed to do.
It is now the next day, and it's time to finish assembling the turntable deck and finish assembling the turntable wall and get this thing all together. Now, the wall assembled, I start working on cutting the bevels in the sides of the walkways on the turntable, and Tony is working on lining up the turntable pit wall. you know, so the turntable doesn't crash into it. And lining things up always takes more time than you expected. And now with final adjustments made, or at least most of the adjustments made, it's time to test this thing out. Yeah, it still hangs up a bit.
Yeah, we gotta level it. Well, I think that's good for this video, because we have the turntable pit in. We still have some adjustments to make to it. I have some adjustments to make to the ring that the outer rollers roll on, and we don't have to make that be a video. I mean, that's kind of boring stuff. So we got the exciting stuff done, and we've proved that the snowplow goes on and off it. So that's a good thing. Well, thanks for watching today's video. Hit that thumbs up button if you did like it. Don't forget the Patreon thing, patreon.com/Millbrook Railroad. If you want early access to videos and some exclusive content. Thanks for watching. Enjoy the rest of your day.